Hi everyone. Today I propose to address a subject of ESP32 connected via Ethernet. As you know, the very popular ESP32 is often used using the Wi-Fi or the Bluetooth, which is a standard configuration. Here I propose to develop with you and to address the subject of an application using the version which is connected by Ethernet. For that, we use two similar boards, ESP32 ETH01 or T32 ETH01. Normally, to develop software for the ESP32, we often use the Arduino IDE system. And with a standard ESP32 boards, it's easy to program or to install the program on board the ESP32, as it's very simple. You can connect it directly via USB and download the code of the program. Now, in this case, with the board with the RG45 connector, we don't have a USB connector on this board, so we have to use temporarily an additional code, which is called FTDI232, and this board is able to convert a USB communication, serial communication, to a standard serial takes RX communication. Here you have the complete wire diagram where we have four wires, the power supplies, obviously, ground and plus 3.3 volt. And you have the takes connected to the RX and the RX connected to the takes of the serial communication. Don't forget to put the jumper on this FTDI board on 3.3 volt because the ESP32 basically is working on 3.3 volt and not 5 volts. To inform the ESP32 that we will download to it a software code, we need to put the GPIO 0 at the ground level before we powered up the ESP32. For example, install a simple switch. You switch on to the ground the GPIO 0 and then you power on the ESP32. And after, you can remove the switch and you are able from your EDI Arduino to download the code to the ESP32. In the future, we will use a capability which is interesting with Arduino is to do the download using OTA on the air. This allows to download of a new code directly using Ethernet and not using this FTDI additional board. Here is a diagram which shows the simple application I propose to develop with you. It's where we have a simple luminosity detector. We have also a DHT22 to measure the temperature and the humidity. You have a BMP180 to measure the atmospheric pressure. And we have also a motion detector to detect any movement close to the system. And I have put also a small LED which blink every 2 seconds in order just to show that the system is running correctly. The main features and temperature, humidity, atmospheric pressure, luminosity, motion detection. Here I have a simple mock-up just to do the test and show that this system work. I have added some software functionality, for example, a watchdog, so you can see in the code how to manipulate the watchdog capability of the ESP32, with interesting feature to survey that the ESP32 is working correctly. We will address also the sleeping mode. Every seconds we put to sleep for 1 second only the ESP32. We have implemented a web server in order to display on a PC or on your smartphone all the measurement we have done of temperature and humidity. And obviously we have installed the OTA functionality in order to be able to upgrade the code later. Here you have an example of the web page on which we display the measurement. If you are interested by a more complex project, they have developed a photovoltaic router with this board. This system, when you have too much energy, too much photovoltaic power, you can transfer this excess of power to water heater. And this is done on this project, which is a quite big one. with 10,000 lines of code. It's available on my website in open source. On my website, f180b.fr, on the home automation section, you will have all the code of this simple application. You have also some explanation. You have a forum on which you can address different subjects, any subject. A lot of people are discussing on this forum. I am on this forum every day, and I provide to you any answer if needed to help you to understand the system. There is also a channel on YouTube, @fox180b. And this YouTube channel, I have all the video I present on the photovoltaic and home automation and ham radio, because F180B is my call sign, my ham radio call sign. It's why the name of this website. So thank you very much for listening to this video, and I wish you an interesting and good development with this board, implementing NSP32 and RJ45 connector to connect directly on Ethernet, which is a more suitable, reliable system to communicate. Thank you again.